the beginning of Thus Spoke Zarathustra, Nietzsche spins this beautiful parable about what it takes for an individual to reach their full potential, for an individual to individuate in the language of Jung, or to become what they are in the language of Nietzsche. And the three metamorphoses are from the man into the camel into the lion, and the lion finally into the child. And these three different stages have their own aspects and roles. They can be kind of contradictory in a way, but each is necessary in their own stage, and each serves its own role on the path to the highest goal of self-actualization. So the man first must become a camel, and this is the stage of apprenticeship in many ways. This is the taking on a heavy load, taking on a heavy burden, and walking through the desert. And so this is the part of our lives we spend learning. This is the part of our lives we spend sitting at the feet of the teacher and absorbing the rules, absorbing the intricacies and the nuances of the craft of life. And this is where we learn the previous knowledge that is out there in order to become the best versions that we can of what's presently out there. And with the second metamorphosis or transformation, the camel becomes a lion. And the lion is very different. The saying comes to mind from the Dalai Lama that learn the rules so you can break them properly. And that's a very good encapsulation of these two stages. So when you're the camel, you learn the rules. But when you become the lion, you break them properly. You turn on them. And in the story of the lion, then he's faced with a dragon. And the lion must slay the dragon. And the dragon, every scale of the dragon glints golden with the message thou shalt. So this is a dragon whose very skin, whose very protection and impenetrability is thou shalt, which is here's what you should do, here's what you have to do, and it's the commandments of society about how you should live your life, here's how things should be done by the book. But the thing is as we look around at the world, we can see that obviously everyone, the people in charge, don't necessarily know exactly what they're doing. The direction of humanity is something that's constantly revolutionizing, each generation is bringing something new as they transform from that mule stage of being a young person going through education into becoming an adult and realizing, knowing enough to see where things can be done better. And that's what the lion does, is he breaks the old rules in order to go about creating something new. In many ways, this means turning on society and what society has done, because as we've all felt, there's the straitjacket of what you're supposed to do, and that keeps you away from following your inner dream, your inner vision, that North Star that guides you from within to what you somehow inherently know to be the right way. And so the lion is the courage to turn back on that dragon and to slay that dragon. But then the lion is not able to create the new values, is not able to reach the full potential himself. And so once the work of slaying the dragon, the work of attacking, the work of pushing back is done, the lion must transform. And the lion transforms into the child. And it seems like an odd thing for a lion to transform into, but this is again tying into that archetype of the divine child. It's the child is innocence. It's untainted by the past, and so it can create something genuinely new. But this isn't the naivety of the young child. This is the eternal child in some way, the divine child, the creator within us all, that sees things with fresh eyes and is able to create something new out of what's there. And something that comes to mind is something that Heraclitus says, that time is like a child playing with blocks. And it taps into the inherent creativity of children. And I think that saying, Heraclitus, is very close to Nietzsche's heart. And what that saying taps into is the impersonality of it all. Because time isn't too fussy about saving individuals' lives. It's about creating something. It creates something grand and then destroys it and creates something grand. And this is the new child creator that the lion has transformed into. And so it's destroyed what's gone before in some way, or it's liberated itself from what's gone before, and now it's free to create something new. And that liberation is the the transformation of the entire individual. It's the individuation process. It's the liberation of your true self. And one important point to make is you can't really skip along the stages. You could go along the spiritual bypassing route and try and come to the child at right off the bat, but the problem is that you end up not really having the nuance to know what you're talking about. So this is why the camel stage is very necessary. You need to actually learn the situation. You need to learn the problem in order that you can actually solve it. And in order to get to the point where you're able to do that, you got to go through the camel stage, and then you got to go through the lion stage, which gives you the courage and the fight and the stance to push back against what's out there now, so you can become the child and create something new and release that new potential into the world. So this analogy, this parable, works on many levels. It works on the societal level, even just on the knowledge level of here's how a new paradigm comes about. You understand the old and you transcend it. But it's also the story most essentially of the individual. It's the individual transforming into what they can be. And in order to do that, you have to go through a number of stages of growth. And that is the story of the three transformations, the three metamorphoses. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, I'd love if you'd subscribe or leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. And otherwise, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.